This is the Truth Network.
Oh, there you are, Peter.
His nose got real big.
Well, welcome back to Neverland, Panda Man.
Don't listen to that stinking fairy and that brainless fungus. I got pan sword on the pan now.
Go to church cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be wasted time. Always stay humble and kind.
Christian Car Guy Radio Show.
I say this calls for action, and now.
Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind.
Gotta stop that pain.
The Anav shall inherit the earth. That's right. You heard me correctly.
Say it again, Robby.
The Anav shall inherit the earth. If you listen closely to the intro, you may have heard Peter Pan. He's finally being recognized. Played by Robin Williams, just a fabulous movie. And in this sense, he has Anav. And because he does, his enemies are wanting to take him out. And then you heard Tim McGraw with Humble and Kind, a fabulous song. And there's some serious Anavness, you know, going on in there. I coined that own word myself, Anavness. But anyway, that's a little Hebrew with an S on it. Anyway. And then you heard How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. I don't remember that show from way back. But I Believe in You is a big part of that. But once again, when you see this person that has Anav, the persecution comes with it almost like, I got to stop that man, right? You heard it? If you watched the movie or saw the Broadway play, you would see that it's a theme that recurs constantly. So on the whole idea of Anav, I think you'll understand it in a minute, Keith. You know, with that in mind, I just love to play, okay?
That's okay. It's time to play. Define that defect. Resolve that roar. Trace that tick. Highlight that hubbub. Name that noise. Chronicle that clatter.
All righty, get ready to call in at 866-348-7884, 866-348-7884. We are going to play Name That Noise, obviously. And if you can name that noise, Keith, tell them what they'll win. Oh, that's the noise. We played the noise rather than what they'll win. But it kind of goes with it anyway, Keith. But you can play the other one. It is time to play. Sometimes
we're going to play.
That's okay. Right. You can just tell them what they'll win. They don't need the music. There it is.
They can win a book from the Christian Car Guy Prize Vault.
All right. You can win a book. All you have to do is call in to name this noise. But let's play the noise one more time by itself, Keith, so they can hear it. All right. I don't know if you think that noise is familiar, but I can assure you it's not a car noise, and it also has everything to do with Anav. And if you know the answer to that, you can call in 866-348-7884. So here's a question for you. How does it feel when someone believes in you, when they have faith in you and they want to serve you, maybe they want to pray for you? If you've met that person, you've met someone who is Anav. So, as always, I'd love to hear these stories. You know, if you've had an Anav person in your life, you know, besides the name, the noise, I would love to hear, you know, just call us at 866-348-7884. So, to give you an example of what an Anav person is, Robby, you know, if you'd have known me when I was little, I was not maybe the brightest kid in the world. I don't know. But my fourth grade teacher actually told my mother that, you know, Little Robby is he's not too bright. I don't believe he will ever graduate from high school. You may want to consider putting him in a special school. And I really did struggle. It was D's and F's for Robby most of all those, you know, third, fourth, fifth grade. They made me repeat the sixth grade. So, you know, now I felt like a real loser. As I repeated the sixth grade. But fortunately, my family moved from Illinois to Grand Blanc, Michigan, and the second time I did sixth grade. So everybody that I saw didn't know I was such a loser. But of course, the teachers knew that I was repeating it. And there was an English teacher. And this English teacher saw something. And she literally thought I was a genius. She called my mother in and she said, "This boy has such a gift. He's so creative. You know, his papers, he can't spell and he can't do grammar," which I can't to this day. But if you look at the, you know, ingenuity and the things he's thinking of, we need to feed this, you know. And so she called my mother in. She had faith in me. She believed in me. And can I tell you the result of this one, just one teacher, okay? After her class, I never got anything below a C, and I was almost a straight A student. I skipped my senior year in high school and went on to college with straight A's. In other words, everything from that teacher on, because one person believed in me, had faith in me, called it out in me, right? And so, you know, in my world, that teacher had a Anav. And so as I tell that story, I'm wondering if you had an Anavite.
You're coming up with all kinds of this.
I'm wondering if you had somebody with a Anav in your life, Jerry. I mean,
oh, yeah. And I'm sitting here thinking, and as soon as we talked about it, and the lead-in song where it says, "Mother made me go to church," and because when I was growing up, I mean, that person, and still is my mom. I mean, really right now she's going through a tough time in her life and stuff with just the issues and trying to get better. But you know, when I was do something stupid, it was always, she was always there, and had five kids, and she was the mother and a friend and supporter. And we did do that. Growing up, I had a drug problem. Every time the doors were open at church, my mom drugged me and all my brothers and my brother and my sisters to church, and, you know, laid that foundation and stuff. And yeah, what a blessing. And you know what, we all have somebody in our life, and you know, like I said, I'd love to hear that. And the other piece of that is, and I don't know how we'll get that far into it, was is the opportunities we miss of being that person in somebody else's life.
Yeah, so where is all this coming from? You may be asking, Robby, what's up with Anav? Well, I'm hoping by the end of the show today, you'll be with me that Anav is one of the coolest words you've ever heard. So you may have heard this from Isaiah 61. "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me because he's appointed me to preach good tidings to the Anav." So maybe you heard it in Matthew 5 when it said, "Blessed are the Anav, for they will inherit the earth." Now, if you go to Numbers 12:2, you really get some insight. Now, the man Moses was very Anav, above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. In Psalms 9, it says, "For the needy shall not always be forgotten. The expectation of the Anav shall not perish forever." That's Psalms 9:8. And of course, in Psalms 37:11, everybody's familiar with, "But the Anav shall inherit the earth and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace." So the word Anav in Hebrew may be the most, in my opinion, misunderstood word I know of. So I'm dropping all its translations for now, and I'm just going to the place where I believe we can get some understanding, because Anav is to hear the good news. If we can understand what Anav is, if we can become an Anav, we can hear the good news. We can inherit the earth. So the first time we find this word is there in Numbers 12, where it says, it describes Moses as a double Anav, right? This is, so in the context of what's happening right there in Numbers 12, right? His big sister has just been trying to bully him, and God steps in and lays leprosy on her, you know, and then in the same chapter, verse 7, is really a key to Anavness, okay? Because God says, "My servant Moses, who is faithful in all mine house. In other words, he's calling Moses a faithful servant. Now, what does that mean? Moses believed in God, but he also believed in Miriam, right? And he also believed, if you think about it, in his people, because he fought for them in prayer. And he believed, even in Pharaoh. I mean, he tried to get him to change his mind, I don't know how many times. I mean, Moses was a faithful servant. Again, according to God, it was the best God has. So what else do we know about Moses? I mean, we know that the guy won't back down from a fight or lose faith, right? He prays for Miriam and gains her healing. So when we come back, we're going to hear your Anav story. Somebody ought to call in on that name, that noise. I'm shocked that you haven't called in. 866-348-7884. We got a lot of Anavness. Some Jesus labor love coming up. You got to stay tuned.
Oh, there you are, Peter.
His nose got real big.
Well, welcome back to Neverland, Panda Man.
Don't listen to that stinking fairy and that brainless fungus. I got pants sort of on the pan now.
Go to church because your mama says to. Visit Grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be wasted time. Always stay humble.
The Anav shall inherit the earth today on the Christian Car Guy Show. I'm very excited to hear. Don't wait till the end of the show to hear to call in with your story.
And you know, people have those stories are sitting there, and just imagine what a blessing it'd be for somebody else to hear your story.
They are. That's what always makes the show, is your phone call. So that's 866-348-7884, 866-34-TRUTH. So to kick off, before we get more into Anavness and understanding where God took me on the whole idea of Anav, let me tell you where he took me on the Jesus Labor Love yesterday. So, you know, amazingly, I just always feel like God is just amazing. He had provided a van from somebody here actually in the Winston-Salem area that had donated a van to the Jesus Labor Love. It needed some tires and some other stuff. And, you know, like always, you're trying to figure out who qualifies for this and whatever. And Bill Mixon, who is our Christian insurance guy, he said, Robby, I hope you got something that's been donated to somebody because we got a lady that really needs help. And this particular lady was a friend of both mine and hers. She used to run the shelter for women that, you know, have been that had drug and alcohol. You know, I mean, this woman had helped I don't know how many other women. I mean, because, you know, we'd, you know, worked with her for years. In fact, she was one of those that would refer people to the Jesus Labor Love. But oh my goodness, he said she's in a bad way, Robby. She needs help. We got to find her a car. And so when this car came available, we had a chance to do that. And yesterday, we had a chance to be there, which is always very fun for the donor to sign over the vehicle to her, and she was in tears. And it's just one of those scenes like, wow, God provided. Well, on the way, you know, I needed to ride back to my car because I'd brought the van down from, you know, actually Haley's European Imports, who'd helped us get this car ready. You know, and I had a chance to talk to her. And oh my goodness, what had happened at that house was exactly this, like living Anav. Because when you see somebody that steps up with Anav, there's going to be people that come. Well, I shouldn't say it's going to be people. When Moses was born, he had a gigantic bullseye on his back that, you know, they tried to kill him before he ever got out of the basket. I mean, from day one, there were people trying to take Moses out. Of course they were, because they, you know, Satan, he had an enemy. You're born with an enemy. And if you have Anav capabilities in you, he is wanting to take you out just like he was wanting to take Jesus out. And he clearly could see that Moses was a huge threat to the kingdom of the world that he had. And so, you know, these people, the Anavites out there, the people that have Anav are going to face persecution, like we heard in the Peter Pan clip, or we heard in the, you know, how to succeed in business without ever even trying. And so, am I, should I be surprised that actually somebody was preying on her clients and taking advantage of them, offering money for favors, so to speak, or drugs and alcohol for favors? And when she tried to blow the whistle on them, guess what happens? She gets fired. And like, oh my goodness. I mean, this was the story I'm hearing, and I'm putting this together because I've been studying this word that you know, God's been trying to point out to me. Well, to go a little farther in the Jesus, labor, love, you know, what happened next was, as I was, well, there was a story where we helped a lady with a fuel pump. It was really, really cool. There was a young man that was at the counter in Raleigh that had heard of the Jesus, labor, love, and he was so excited. He told me he was going to donate a car, a Isuzu Trooper, and so that was really cool. I give him a shout out. I mean, it was really neat. He helped out these folks that needed a fuel pump. So I had that was. Yeah, really
what was the name of the parts? What do you know the name of the parts store?
Yeah, it was Auto. Not AutoZone. The other one starts with
Advance.
Auto. Yeah.
Advance.
No, it was
AutoZone. It was never mind. In Raleigh.
Forgive me. I forgot. It was one of those, you know, like O'Reilly's or someplace like that. It was, you
Napa.
Know. No, it no, was. I think it was AutoZone.
AutoZone.
So, as I am leaving the, you know, and a lot of these folks that we've helped over the years that I prayed for, I gave them my phone number because, you know, we got to tell me when they need parts and stuff. So, I'm pulling through the drugstore and I'm handing, you know, and all of a sudden I see this call come in from a really strange area code, which, you know, based on my age, I think somebody's trying to sign me up for Medicare Plus or something. But then I noticed it says maybe, and then it gave somebody's name, which sounded a little bit familiar to me. So I said, well, maybe I should call him back. So as soon as I cleared out the, you know, I called, and oh my goodness, what God wanted to show me. She said, do you remember me? You know, you helped my family back last summer. And by that, she means you helped the listeners, okay, that provided the money and the prayers and all that stuff. But that's what she's saying. But you helped our family, the ministry helped our family back last summer. We needed brakes and rotors and da-da-da-da, and you really helped us, and I really, really appreciate it. And now I'm wondering, you know, yesterday the engine froze in our car, and I know you probably can't help us financially, but I'm wondering if you could just pray for us. And you may have heard me talk. I hope you've listened to the show a lot, and you understand that one of the big things we get a chance to do is just connect these people to God. I mean, that's where the real source of stuff comes. So I said, well, you know, first of all, you know, tell me where you are, because, you know, this area code doesn't make sense to me. And she says, well, I'm in Lexington, Kentucky. And I said, okay. Remind me what's going on. And she's like, well, my husband has a liver issue. He's on a list to get a liver transplant. So we make a lot of trips back and forth to the doctor. And so we are really, really in need. When this car breaks down, it puts us in a hard way. We've got a teenage daughter, and as she's explaining this story, my heart is just, you know, oh my goodness, I just can't believe God, you've got me here. And then I said, well, you know, can we pray? You know, let me pray, because I don't know anybody in Lexington right now that has a car, but we can ask on the air tomorrow if somebody in Lexington, Kentucky, because we have a station that carries us there. Thank you, praise God that we do. And so when I said, can I pray for you? You know, she said, can I put you on speaker so my husband can hear the prayer? And she's lucky I could get it out. You know, it's just like, oh my goodness. I mean, God, here we are. And so fascinatingly, you know, this week, God had a lady from Denver, Colorado that contacted us also with a friend whose daughter had been murdered that needs a car. Those are at, by the way, ChristianCarGuy.com, those prayer requests and those needs. But the point is, Anav, okay? Like, having faith in people, and it's really going to be cool. You can see where God's going with his word. But we need your calls, 866-348-7884. Robby Dillmore here, and the Truth Network podcasts have helped make MyPillow the company it is today. And now Mike Lindell, who, by the way, I've met and is a great guy, the inventor and CEO of MyPillow, wants to give back to our listeners. For the first time, you can get deep discounts on all MyPillow products if you go to MyPillow.com right now and click on the new radio listener specials. Who never thought that my dream job would be selling MyPillows? Maybe you're getting tired of these sleeping jokes, but you can get deep discounts on MyPillows, mattress toppers, bed sheets, and so much more. For example, the body pillow is regularly $89.99, but with a promo code GETTRUTH, it's only $29.99. Remember, all MyPillow products come with a 60-day money-back guarantee and a 10-year warranty. Just go to MyPillow.com and click on the new radio listener specials and get deep discounts on all MyPillow products, including the body pillow, for only $29.99. Enter promo code GETTRUTH or call 800-942-9613 for these great radio specials.
Hold the door,
said please, said thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind.
Gotta stop that plan.
Oh, I believe in you.
Don't let him be such a hero.
The Anav shall inherit the earth today on the Christian Car Guys show. Keith, I'm just shocked that nobody has called in to name this noise, because I thought it was just like unbelievably easy. So we want people to win a book from the Christian Car Guy Prize Vault. All you have to do is call in at 866-348-7884. Name this noise. Go ahead, Keith. Well, our computer just... There you go. If you can name that noise, you can win. 866-348-7884. And as I told you, it's going to have something to do with Anav. It's going to have something to do with what we've been talking about today. And so you can tell God's had me, you know, as I was experiencing these things with the Jesus Labor Love yesterday, I had this word Anav in my mind, and I had been looking at it in Hebrew, and I could see it in my brain as I was driving home from my daughter's last night. And as I looked at the letters, I just began to ask God, you know, how does this fit together? What am I missing here? And so to get into that, which, by the way, there's a beautiful picture of it at ChristianCarGuy.com. If you haven't seen these Hebrew letters or the study that goes into what they represent, it's all there at ChristianCarGuy.com. I gave you links to beautiful videos that show this stuff that I'm going to explain here in a second. But there's only three letters, so it's pretty easy. The first letter is an ion. And if you were to look at that ion on my website, you would see that it really looks like two eyes that are connected with an optic nerve, right, that goes into one nerve. And not surprisingly, in Hebrew, the word ayin means eyes. It means to look, to see. And so, you know, when you think of the word that most people translate this as meek or humble or whatever else, there's nothing about seeing in that. So I immediately knew that, you know, why would this letter start with eyes? What would eyes have to do with it? And I knew that Moses was a picture of it because he was double Anav, right? So, but it clearly started with these eyes. And the second letter is what they call a nun, and it means faithful servant, okay? And so much of what you hear about, you know, humble and poor and all this stuff, that comes from that nun in the middle of the word, which means faithful. And don't miss that because it's huge. Faithful servant. Okay, he's not just a servant. He is a faith. In other words, he believes in you and he believes in God. And then the last letter is what they call a vav, which is just V-A-V, and it's just a straight line. But if it's at the end of a word like that, it always is a connecting word, but it really connects heaven to earth. And it's a vertical line, and it has to do with vertically. So when I started to just question God, how does this fit together? I finally saw it on my way home last night. I was like, oh, well, that makes perfect sense. Here's what it means. Moses was looking. He was searching. He was, you know, he was hungry to be a faithful servant to God and his brothers and sisters vertically. In other words, he wanted to be a servant to these people and helping them connect to God vertically. That's why he gave them the law. That's why he argued for them, you know, and actually got God to repent. And this guy was not by anybody's, you know, the word meek in English doesn't even come close to this guy. I mean, this guy argued with God. He argued with Pharaoh. He killed an Egyptian. I mean, this guy is you know, this, but the reason he did all that stuff was not for himself. He did it, right, in service to others. You know, he did it when he prayed to God to heal his sister. I mean, here's this lady that put him down because he married the wrong, you know, and all that stuff. So when you begin to see this looking to serve others over myself vertically, okay, you begin to get the feel of what that word Anav really means. And those guys are the ones that are going to hear the good news. And those guys are the ones that are going to inherit the earth. You know, Jerry, it's a beautiful thing. In my view, it's just gorgeous.
Yeah, we, you know, we sit there and we're thinking about that. And you know, it's not, a lot of information there. But yeah, the thing is, we always, what we interpret now is the meek, and Moses certainly wasn't meek. And, you know, except for one thing, the meekness was himself, where he was surrendering himself for others. And that's, man, that's powerful. And as you mentioned early on, talking about, you know, when Moses did have a target on his back, and anytime we're doing God's will and trying to further the kingdom, we also have a target on our back, because that certainly we're in, Satan has got us in the scope. I mean, because he's going to throw things and relationships and everything that means something to us at us.
I love that line in that musical, "Don't let him be such a hero," right? Which is kind of where Aaron and Miriam were in this. Don't let Moses get, well, Moses wasn't trying to be a hero. Moses was trying to serve his God, and he was trying to serve his brothers and sisters. But if you do that, don't be surprised that, you know, with that comes persecution and those kind of things. But the beautiful thing is that we can really ask God to be an Anav. I mean, we can ask him, God, how can I, right? And part of that is praying, because you saw what Moses did for Miriam. How did she end up getting healed? It was prayer. How did come the people weren't just all eaten up in the desert? You know, it was Moses' intercession was a big part of what was going on. And so you may have heard me tell these stories about the Jesus labor love. And right by the end of the segment, I mentioned there's a lady in Colorado who's, one of her daughters was murdered, and she's struggling. The whole story is there at ChristianCarGuy.com. Oh my goodness, we can pray for her. Oh my goodness, we can pray for a lady that is in Lexington, Kentucky, that I just told you about with the husband with the liver thing. And then there's another lady there that needs a car, that is in the Winston-Salem, Greensboro area, North Carolina. You know, she's only 20 years old. And unfortunately, you know, based on a boyfriend that just left, you know, after the baby was born, and she's left with a family that's trying to keep all this stuff together. And she really wants to get a job, but she's got to get a car, and they don't have one. And there you go. And so we can, I know these, in all situations, people made choices. But see, that didn't stop Moses from praying for these people. I mean, he prayed for his brother after he, you know, made a golden calf.
Yeah, with Moses, I mean, yeah, he was surrounded by people who made choices. Most of the time, a lot of bad choices, but never did it affect his desire to connect. I love that word picture you said about the ladder connecting us to heaven and stuff. You know, that was always his focus, and that should be ours.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous thing. So, you know, I feel blessed out of my socks, really, that God would entrust us with the ministry that he has. And, you know, daily get a chance to see how he comes vertically for people. And you know, one of the things that blessed me the most about that phone call yesterday was that she says, I know you probably can't help us again financially, but can you pray for us? Oh, my gosh. I mean, Lord, thank you. I mean, it's a phenomenally beautiful thing, and it would be a phenomenally beautiful thing for you to call in with your Anav story. Now, we're almost, you know, we got one more segment here to go. We need your calls. I mean, obviously, this is where, I mean, I get to hear how somebody else Anav'd out, man. I mean, I know they're out there, and I know you're sitting on it. So call us, 866-348-7884. And if you want to give a shot at that Name That Noise, Keith, you think we can play it one more time? This is not hard, folks. I mean, not trying to fool you or anything. It's not a car noise, okay? But it is a noise that has to do with a Anav. 866-348-7884. All still quiet on the Western Front. We have all our lines open. And so, you know, I'm just going to say, Jerry, we need him to call.
Yeah, we need to hear. Like I said, sometimes we think their stories are, you know what, that's corny, or I don't want to. But man, most of the time when we tell our story, man, we don't know who that is going to encourage and point them to share their story, and also maybe even bring them to the understanding that there's hope. And I think, you know, through prayer, one of the things that God, you know, that avenue he gives us through prayer is hope, that he brings us hope, and he is our hope. And when we humble ourselves, and I think that's, you know, the other piece about Moses, it was it was always humbled himself to do the will of other people and stuff, and to serve them, and especially to serve God. And even when he didn't always agree and stuff, and would have those battles with God, I mean, it was still.
That's what he was looking for. And don't you think it's, I think it's amazing personally that he was the guy that saw the burning bush, right? Yeah. I mean, that there was a burning bush up there, and who knows who could have seen it, but it was the guy with the eyes to go, oh, there's something cool going up on that mountain. I'm headed up there because that looks like this could be it, what I've been looking for. So we have got one more segment to hear your story, and I'll be so happy if you call 866-348-7884. We got one more segment coming up. Stay tuned. The Anav will inherit the earth today on the Christian Car Guy Show. We are very excited now. We're very excited because we have callers. And this is what I was waiting for all show. And this is what I'm very excited about. We have Deborah is in Seattle, Washington. Oh, wonderful. Deborah, you're on the Christian Car Guy Show. Good morning.
Good morning. It is early to me.
I know. But we're so excited to hear your story.
Well, I actually have two little stories, and then one about learning to drive.
Go ahead.
But I'll try and make it short. My first story was when I was probably maybe in fourth grade. I was an active child, but I was dyslexic, and so I didn't read well. I didn't have interest in reading, and after I had done a dance. You know, those talent show thing.
Right.
The librarian came up to me and said, "You like to move, don't you? You like activity. And I have some stories that you might like to read about activity and adventure." And I thought, "Oh, I don't think I'd be interested." But she said, "You just give it a try." And she just took such an interest in who I was. I was so quiet. But movement was what I, and so these two books that she gave me really did turn out to be, really made me want to read more. So that was delightful. And I always remember her kindness in just coming to me and trying to speak my language, even though she probably, it wasn't her thing, but she reached out. And then, my second story was later in seventh grade, and it was the centennial year in Canada, and they had the schools doing all this track and field stuff, the standing broad jump and all these different things, running the 220, the 880, the 440. I was just active. I didn't pay much attention to sports or anything, but the gym teacher, she came alongside me and she said, "You can do this. You can get gold in each one of them. You can do it." And I just always remembered her being over me because I really couldn't have cared less. I just didn't even imagine winning anything. But with her encouragement and joy in who I was, I won gold in everything. It was because of her.
Oh, my goodness.
Really, I always remembered that. So, and my last story is about learning to drive with my father. Our landscape was really quite flat. And so, I mean, you know, the winter and everything is, that's something you have snow banks to drive into if you go off the road, basically.
Yeah.
But, I don't know, we were coming back from somewhere and it was a bit hilly and it was dark. And following the double yellow lines and going uphill, but all of a sudden, I said to my dad, "Dad, where did the lines go? They just stopped." You know, because it was a hill.
Right.
The lines stopped. And he said, "Keep driving. Keep driving." I was terrified because I thought the land just dropped off somewhere. And that was a lesson to me as far as when we're going on in life and we don't know where we're going, and God says, keep driving, keep moving.
What a and the beautiful one about that is it came from your father, Ryan?
Yes.
And
yes.
And you could hear that voice. I'm sure that is just beautiful. And I think you've encapsulated the word Anav. I mean, it's just beautiful.
Yes.
Thank you, Deborah. Yes. And now you've had the courage to actually call in and a national radio show. So that's pretty impressive.
Thanks. Were very special stories in my life, and I'm glad to be able to share them with you. It's early for me, so I will let you go and get on with my day.
Well, thank you again so much. I am delighted. You made my day. I can assure you. God bless. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
And I mean, wow.
A lot in that story.
In all three of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can hear it. And God sends these people into our lives, you know, to call us out.
And then I always say, man, it is, the reality is that so many times we miss those opportunities to be that person in somebody else's life. I mean, you know, because it was just nothing beside your story. I mean, and then her stories, and it was just somebody, just a word of encouragement that made an impact that you'll remember for a lifetime.
Yeah, and impact other people. You know, right. is another light gets lit. We have Paula is in Snow Camp, North Carolina. Paula, you're on the Christian Car Guy Show. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. So I was going to try to make the sound.
All right, I'm excited to hear. Let's play it one more time, Keith, so that she can hear it. All right, what do you think that is, Paula?
Well, I have a couple ideas, but I'm going to go with it. It sounds like it's Clarence the Angel for George Bailey, who, you know, he encouraged him throughout that whole thing, so he got his wings. I mean, that's what it reminds me of.
Now that makes oh my goodness, that's so much better answer.
Yeah,
than
that's a winner right there.
I mean, he did. You're right, and he did encourage George. He had an off. I mean, that's no doubt. That's beautiful. I recorded that noise, but I did not know when I was doing that. But I'm thinking that he probably did get, somebody got some wings when I rang that bell. It's beautiful. I love that. I love that. Thank you. What was some of your other guesses?
Well, then it also sounds like, you know, when you walk up to a counter, old style, where I grew up, there was always a little bell on the counter, and you could ding it a few times to get someone's attention for help.
Yeah, it's a service. So it's a service bell. Yeah. And that's exactly right. You're a winner. But you're a winner on the Clarence.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, you won two ways to Sunday. I mean, we may have to send you two books because they're just two great answers.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so excited.
You had the correct answer, and you even had the better answer.
Yeah, you had the correct answer and the better answer. So I'm liking the Clarence answer. I wish I'd thought of that. That's awesome. Thank you, Paula. God bless. I'm going to put you on hold, and Keith's going to get your information. Sure. That's... you know, just amazing. You may have time to get one more, you know, story in if you got time. You know, you touched your heart and you want to call 866-348-7884. And I need to point out that all this stuff is at ChristianCarGuy.com. All the spelling of the word Anav and the letters and beautiful videos that show how those letters are formed and what they mean, and all the scripture references that we used, as well as the Jesus labor love prayer requests. You know, how you can pray for these people and all this stuff.
Let me ask something on that, and I'm not sure if I... Do you still have the T-shirts if somebody donates $25?
Yes,
or any donation, isn't it?
Any donation. Just ask.
Yeah, ask
when
for
you
the
donate
t-shirt.
For the T-shirts. Yes, we definitely have those. But I also wanted to mention that I am getting a chance. I was offered a chance to preach at Good Shepherd Baptist Church in Greensboro. So if you're in the Greensboro, Winston-Salem area, you want to hear me tomorrow, by all means, I would love to see you. It's at 1015 4453 Summer Church Road in Greensboro, North Carolina. I will be there. Looking forward to see who wants to come out. And, you know, I want to see if I can be an Anav to somebody. You know, that's just, it sounds like too much fun to think that, wow, you could make that kind of impact in somebody's life, you know, that would make all the difference. And so, you know, part of that is you probably ought to slow down. Jesus walked everywhere he went and got it all done in 33 years. But Jerry, what do you think?
Yeah, like I said, it's just, you know what, this morning has been a cool morning. I mean, it really has.